have a bit of a theory. I believe that the way that you organize yourself with pen and paper might be one of the best ways to figure out what digital project or task management tool is going to be the best fit for your personality. It's just a theory. Throughout this video, I'm going to be going through 6 different personality types. 6, yes. And each of those personality types, I'm going to talk about how they might organize themselves in an analog, meaning like pen and paper or very low-tech way. And then I'm going to give a prediction as to what project management or task management tool is going to be the best fit for that personality type. But because it'd be kind of fun and I'd love to hear your unbiased opinion, I'd like you to join me in this guessing game. So as we go through here, we're going to go through 6 different personalities. And before, this is important, before I tell you my answer, I want you to type into the chat your answer. Okay, so number 1, blank. Number 2, blank. Tell me what tool you think I'm going to say before I say it. Post it in the comments below, and we're going to compare our data to see if we can make our predictor a little bit more helpful here. So personality type number 1 is the sticky notes master. You are someone who has a pile of sticky notes near you at any point in time, whether it's on your laptop, in your notebook, on your desk, in your mirror, in your car, there are sticky notes somewhere. You swear by them because not only can you remember what you wrote, you can remember what color the sticky note was, what pen color you had, and where that sticky note is most of the time. As a sticky note master, you're probably a little resistant to go onto online tools, but if you were to digitize your task management system, my hunch is that you would be a good fit for, this is your reminder to vote in the comments, Trello. I believe Trello is going to be one of the closest comparisons to your sticky note-based system because not only is it extremely simple, just like a sticky note, it also gives you that ability to just arbitrarily make categories for things or rearrange things. It's not quite a flexible canvas, but it's close, and it will allow you to have a little bit more organization when you get into those dozens or hundreds of sticky notes, which in analog systems can become a bit overwhelming. So personality type number 1, Trello. A close relative to our sticky note aficionados is our bulletin board enthusiasts out there. Now, any of you who have ever worked as a teacher, I imagine this is part of your genome, but the bulletin board folks, you are someone who doesn't just like to have sticky notes. No, no, no. You've promoted it from sticky to pushpin or tape, if you feel really fancy, and you like to arrange your thoughts not just on small pieces of paper, like a sticky note person might. You also like to mix in different medias. You might take scraps of paper from a meeting. You might take an agenda. You like to hodgepodge it all together into a collage of organization. That is your bulletin board. And for the record, if you are a whiteboarder, I'm going to put you in this group as well. If you are someone who finds yourself having the most luck when you're able to mix different medias together and arrange them in a very particular format, you're probably going to find digitizing a bit uncomfortable. Because the fact is, collecting all those different mediums, that newspaper clipping, that agenda from a meeting, that handout, that collection is going to require a bit of work. But if you are committed to digitizing, in my opinion, the best project or task management system for you might be something like, quick pause here for you guys to vote in the comments. What do you think the answer is going to be? MyLaNote. So I don't know if you guys are familiar with that. MyLaNote is kind of like a whiteboarding canvas, but with a bit more of a creative skew in my mind versus things like Miro and Whimsical, which are more straight up whiteboards. MyLaNote has, yeah, like just a more creative element to it. It allows you to pull in images more easily and make things a little bit more aesthetically pleasing. So for those of you who are used to using mood boards, bulletin boards, whiteboards to organize your life, your feelings, your things, MyLaNote is my guess as to your best project management tool if you're going to take your exact habits that you have now and bring them into the digital space. All right, so we've talked about a lot of our mixed media creatives here, right? Folks who are going to grab sticky notes, are going to grab a bulletin board and organize their lives that way. But the next personality type is a little bit more calm than that, a little bit more measured. The third personality type I'm talking about today is, of course, the bullet journaler. I can't say I fully understand how a bullet journaler's mind works, how they space out all of their things and color coordinate and use iconography and different lists to organize all of their thoughts, but I do think I know where the best place for them would be on the internet. If you wanted to take bullet journaling, right? These sections and colors and codes and layouts and goal setting, all done manually, and bring that into the digital space, there's a particular tool that comes to mind for you. And again, go ahead and vote in the comments. But what I think would be your best digital pair would be Notion. Now, I feel like Notion has really become mainstream here in the last few years, but if you're not familiar, Notion is like a flexible canvas with kind of a doc-based structure that allows you to organize all sorts of data using database elements, but also a lot of aesthetic and just organizational features. A few months prior to the time of recording this video, Notion did purchase Automate.io, so this recommendation may change in the future. But at the time of recording, Notion is still overwhelmingly a manual system. And for folks who enjoy that kind of meditative work of manually creating links, manually filling out those dots, manually organizing their bullet journal, I think you'll find Notion delightfully manual in a digital space. But I know manual isn't for everybody, and especially this next personality type, manual is definitely not your friend. Now, this next personality type, I am lovingly going to refer to as the inbox hoarder. The inbox hoarder manages their entire life out of their email inbox. Every single thing they need to do, even if it's a quick thought they had at the grocery store, gets emailed to themselves. When they're looking to start their day, they start it inside their inbox. Every single moment in this person's life, every single thing they have to do, thing they need to say, thing they need to see, is all inside their inbox. Usually, paired with some pretty ridiculous labels or folder-based systems, maybe even some forwarding or automations, everything is archived or saved for historical purposes because you could not imagine not having a copy of that random shower thought 13 years from now when you're looking for that email later. That is the MO of our inbox hoarder. And while insanely productive in their own right, the inbox hoarders probably feeling a bit isolated in their inbox. Especially if this inbox hoarder starts to work with other people, they might find that sending emails back and forth become a bit frustrating, and they're gonna start shopping into the world of, again, task management or project management tools. And what is gonna be the closest match to the inbox hoarder's existing status quo if they want to flip into a task management tool? Guesses? My vote would be for Basecamp. Now, Basecamp, if you're not familiar, is a task management tool kind of skewed towards teams in the service space because things are so grouped around projects. And if you are someone who's used to already kind of compartmentalizing everything into folders and subfolders or sublabels inside your inbox, I think you'll find Basecamp a pretty similar way of organizing your thoughts. By the way, if you're still watching this video and you haven't liked and subscribed,
what are you doing?
Now, for our fifth personality type we're going to be talking about today, I want us to take a step away from the digital and think about that person who has their tasks organized, but in a spiral-bound notebook. Now, this person is definitely related to our bullet journaler and maybe have even done a little bit of bullet journaling at some point, but they find themselves wanting a bit more flexibility. They find themselves creating lists, and then working through that list and then creating another list and working through that list. The spiral-bound notebook person has maybe a few sections inside their notebook or notebooks, and they just have running lists of things they need to do. That list never really changes. It just keeps getting added to over time. There may be some separation of, you know, here's my someday list, here's my today list, but the lists are just kind of there, and that trusty notebook follows them everywhere. Where this person differs from the bullet journaler is they're not quite getting that meditative effect of, you know, organizing and taking the time to really reflect on their work, which I think, to me at least, is part of that bullet journal appeal, that reflection. The spiral-bound notebook person is a little bit more action-oriented. They don't really care about all that. They just need a place to get ideas out of their head quickly, keep track of tasks, and cross them off. Simple, simple, simple. For this person, I think you have a very clear digital pairing if you wanted to bring your practices online. What's your guess? I'll tell you what mine is. My guess is that you would get along very well with Asana if this is your personality style, because Asana is a no-nonsense, straightforward task management system. And especially if you ignore their half-hearted attempt at views and their subtasks, Asana is pretty much as close as you can get to that spiral-bound notebook. In Asana, you can have several lists, you can organize your tasks into those lists, and if you're like most Asana users, you end up having quite a few lists that just endlessly get added to as you have new projects or teams. And just like the spiral-bound notebook person ends up having probably many binders or many spiral-bound books that they're carrying around at all times, Asana is also built for having a lot of different teams or clusters of projects working together. And it can be a lot, but it's also very spread out, just like your spiral-bound notebook. So now that brings me to last but not least, and that is our agenda people, okay? Our people with an agenda. These are folks who are used to working on a week-by-week planner, which they are frequently rewriting tasks from one list to the next list. That's the main difference here between our bullet journalers and our spiral-bound notebook people and our agenda folks. These agenda folks will write down their tasks, and they'll often rewrite those same tasks in different organizations. So if they were a student, they might write down individual pieces of homework on each class, and then at the end of the day, they would rewrite that same information into one master task list for the evening. And at the end of that day, they might rewrite all of that into a master list for the quarter or for the month or for the year. This kind of rewriting, which is somewhat similar to bullet journaling, but again, less reflective, this is kind of the tell for me in the agenda person, because you like to have your information captured very granularly, and then you like to also see it in multiple different ways, because seeing it in that granular detail isn't often enough. For you, my agenda-loving friend, I have a text suggestion for you. If you want to leave the paper agenda world behind, the paper planner behind, there's some tech that might be right up your alley. Pause for you to vote. And I'm actually kind of cheating on this one because my answer is three different tools, either Todoist, ClickUp, or Monday.com. I know it's kind of cheating for me to give you three as the answer for this, but I want to clarify which of those three is going to be right for you. If you are someone who is switching into digital task management exclusively for yourself, Todoist, my friend, is where I would send you first. I think that's going to be the closest match. And also, it's just an awesome tool. And if you are looking to organize that agenda-loving self inside a digital tool, Todoist is where I would send you. Todoist is really strong in personal task management. Its ability to understand natural language makes it really intuitive. And it's just so clean when you're using it. It's an absolute delight for those of you who love planners. If you are not solo, however, and you are looking to bring that digital planner into a more collaborative space, I think that's where ClickUp and Monday really have an edge, because Todoist, at this point, it just doesn't scale that well. It's very personal driven. And when you have a team, it doesn't quite work. So between ClickUp and Monday, which one's going to be the right choice? Well, I would look back at your analog habits to make that decision if we're going to give you a personality fit. If you are someone who has a paper agenda and you've been using that agenda the same exact way for the past, let's say, 12 to 18 months or more, I think you would like Monday.com more. The consistency, the polish, the care that goes into some of the features that they release, I think that would more align with your needs as someone who likes a planner or agenda-based system, and you like that stability and consistency of having a known, predictable kind of structure. However, if you are someone like me, who when you had an agenda, you were constantly rearranging it. Sometimes you'd put due dates on the date of the week. Sometimes you'd have a list section. Sometimes you'd be using reference notes. If you were constantly changing the organization of your personal planner or agenda, I think you might be a ClickUp person. Welcome to the party. ClickUp users tend to be more appreciative of flexibility. Just like Monday or Todoist, you have multiple ways to view the same information. But with ClickUp, they have a kind of a strong personality as a company. They're very forward-looking. They're constantly changing their platform. And that instability, which sounds kind of like a negative, and it kind of is, comes with a lot of positives of innovation and creativity and the newest, hottest, greatest features that other tools then copy. So if you are someone that likes to mix things up, to see what's new, to always try to improve your own personal system, and you have a team, and you're an agenda brain, I think ClickUp would be a good fit for you. But of course, everything I said here is just my own little pet theory of how analog personality types translate into digital spaces. I asked you guys at the onset here to track your responses and leave them in the comment below. And if you haven't already, click enter now. I would love to hear, what did you think? Where did you and I differ? And what are your thoughts? Because oftentimes I think people who are trying to go from an analog system into digital organization, they get burnt out mainly because they're trying the wrong tools. They're making it really hard for themselves versus taking those baby steps. And if we can find systems that closely correlate or very similar to what you're used to, well, that's a lot easier, right? You've already got the hurdle of going digital. Why make it even harder by forcing your brain to work a way it doesn't like to work. At least that's my theory. So thank you guys so much for watching and for entertaining my little entertaining foray into personality types and task management tools. If this does help you find the best project management tool for you, please let us know in the comments. I'd love to hear it. But until next time, thanks for watching and enjoy the process.